Welcome to The Journey. Today we're going to talk about how to get customer feedback for your business. So when you think about collecting customer feedback for your business, which I hope you're doing all the time, it's easy to get overwhelmed by the volume of possibilities. Trust me. And with so many customers and so many ways to connect with their feedback, it can be hard to know where to start. Well, one thing is clear, taking a proactive approach to collecting customer feedback ensures that you never stray too far from the needs of your community, even as those needs evolve.
Feedback is a powerful guide that can give you the insights that chart a path forward for every aspect of your business. A customer survey helps you harness those insights and identify ways that sets your business apart. It's important to develop customer surveys that collect and show useful insights and also get shoppers and clients to complete your survey. And we're going to show you how.
Let's start with tips for creating a customer survey. Well, before you start writing your customer survey questions, here are some best practices to keep in mind. I would say, first off, know your goals before you begin. It's good advice for most beginnings. And don't blindly create a customer survey just because you know you should. Instead, consider what you want to gain from the survey. And I would suggest outlining, you know, your business goals before you begin and ask yourself a few questions. Like, first off, hey, do you want to gather feedback to improve a product or service? Ask yourself, do you want to learn about your customers? Another great question, do you want to improve the customer experience? Knowing what you want to learn will help you to craft better questions for your survey.
Exactly. You also want to consider all question formats. So as you develop the questions for your survey, think about what format might help you collect the best feedback. Use a mix of multiple choice, yes, no's, open-ended, and even sliding scales.
To gain additional insight, also be sure to ask follow-up questions. Definitely consider that. Also make sure that they're relevant. So for example, follow up with a yes or no question with an open-ended why question. Another way to gain better insight is to ask how questions. Don't ask, hey, do you like the product? Instead, ask how well would you rank the product? Or maybe you could ask, how would you describe the product? So Neely, I got a how question for you. How well am I doing explaining how to get customer feedback for your business?
Is there a non-answer or an other?
Wow, Neely. Well, it's a good segue. Speaking of non-answers, this is something you should also include in your survey. If a survey taker must select an answer, allow them to choose a non-answer if they just don't want to, or maybe they can't respond. So essentially add options for like, I don't know, or other, kind of like what Neely wanted to do right now with my question.
So my answer remains, I don't know, Emma, but don't lead on survey takers is our next tip here for you. To really get the most useful and truthful answers, you're not going to want to put words in the mouth of your survey takers. Positive feedback is great. We love to hear it, but only when it's true. So don't use leading questions that guide your users to say what you want to hear. Because if there's information that you need to change and you'll never hear it, you'll never change and your business will never improve.
Also, another great tip, be specific. You know, you can gather better insights if you are more specific in your question. And I have an example of this. For example, don't ask, how would you rate the overall customer experience? That's pretty broad. I would encourage you to be specific and ask something more like, how would you rate the onboarding process?
Now that we know what goes into the survey, let's talk about how to get people to actually fill them out. You can spend a lot of time perfecting this questionnaire, but there's still a good chance that not everyone will want to fill it out. So let's make sure you're getting a fair ROI. Starting off with just keep it short and sweet. You don't want your survey to feel like work for your customers. People have a lot of other things that they need to do. So keeping it short so it doesn't take too much time and energy to complete. And when you conduct a survey, try to keep it to about 5 to 10 questions max.
Great point, Neely. Also, be upfront about the length and time it will take to complete. I know for me, when I see a survey, oftentimes I'm a little hesitant. But if I see, oh, this is only going to take 5 to 10 minutes, done. Happy to proceed. And right away, you know, you're letting customers know what is expected from them before that survey starts. So in other words, you're setting expectations. Let them know even how many questions are included and how long it will probably take them.
Love that. Let me know up front, because I don't want to go on and just like, all right, next page, next page, next page. How long is this thing? But with your survey, make sure you show the benefit. Show how this survey is going to benefit your business and ultimately them too. Let them know what you're going to do with the results and how you will use their insights to improve. So consider using language like, help us improve, fill out this survey to tell us how we can get better at insert your service here.
It has me wondering, Neely, do we have a survey for the journey? I want to know, how are we doing? Which takes us to our last point, ask at the right time. Be mindful of the customer's journey with your brand as you decide when to present shoppers or clients with a survey. Timing's everything, right? So for example, you might not want to push a survey on a customer only a few minutes after they do business with your brand for the first time.
By following these tips and best practices, you can create a customer survey that will help you gain valuable insights about your business. You can use what you learn to improve your brand and create better products, services, and experiences.
You just learned how to get customer feedback for your business, and your journey's not over there. So be sure to check out over 200 additional videos that will help your business thrive. This is a journey.